still better, sir.
The only address I can give now is my Hoboken address now.
Because address.
Good. So, friends, first of all, thank you, President Ravi. Friends, it's a great privilege for me to introduce somebody like Suresh Hari, whom I had the pleasure of knowing even much before our Rotary years as a round tabler, an excellent, very active and vibrant round tabler that he was, who also headed the round table movement as its president, national president, which of course he has listed in his CV. But what I would like to add here, that as a tabler, his dedication to service and activity and fellowship of people and man management and getting people with him has been exemplary, which he further proved in Rotary also. I would now like to make a formal introduction as given by Suresh himself. So I'll be reading out from his CV. Suresh is a first generation entrepreneur, and he founded Vishal Promoters and Builders in 1989 and continues to be its managing partner, where property development is its core activity. He joined Rotary in 1996 through Rotary Club of Indiranagar and then went on to become its president in 2006 and 7. Some of the personal involvements of his in club activities and district projects. He was the grant chair for matching grant and global grant, and value of grants handled by him was about US$611,000 for his club and about $34 million for the district. Supported the club in raising US$1 million towards club projects and foundation giving, including motivating two senior members reaching AKS level. He was the chair of dialysis consumable support program, and about 3,000 plus dialysis cycles supported so far. Governor Special Representative for Rotary Malagudi, core group in implementing Bharatiya Gramin Mahila Sangh project with outlays of US$0.45 million. He served in Rotary in various capacity for the past 10 years, and some of them are recognized for exemplary service to foundation by the Rotary Foundation through district during 2012-13, TRF cadre of technical advisors, recognized at South Asia Literacy Summit for US$77,000 sponsorship support from CREDAI. Suresh are multiple major donors to TRF and sourced the first Arch C Club Society member of the district during 2012-13. The member of CREDAI is a senior builder award holder conferred on him by the Builders Association of India. As I said, he was national president of Roundtable India during 1995. He has chaired national level panels on migrant labor issues and part of labor committee at the CREDAI national level, chaired two editions of CARE Awards by CREDAI Karnataka, organized state level convention of CREDAI Karnataka, StateCon in Bangalore, and was secretary for the first NATCon conducted by CREDAI. Association constitution expert and author of CREDAI Karnataka and its chapter constitution as part of National Constitution Committee of CREDAI National. Member of the conciliatory group of dispute resolution cell constituted by RERA authority or government of Karnataka. Member of Bangalore Kendra Committee of Bharatiya Vidya Bhavan created a record of sorts by facilitating the first largest Rotary Foundation pledge of US$14.7 million by fellow Rotarian President Ravi Shankar the Goji of Rotary Club of Bangalore Orchard during 2018-19, and this was the largest single individual pledge in the Rotary world. World number one ranking district 3190 during 2018-19 for the TRF giving of 3.05 million. E Mega Zone 7 for the period 2020-23 is a member National TRF CSR Committee. On a personal level, he was born to Parvati and late Swaminathan Iyer. He did his post-graduation in economics from Madras University and is an alumni of IIM Bangalore. He is happily married to Anita and their two children. A daughter, Janani, who is married to Mahesh, and the couple have two children, Vikram and Adhira, and their son, Akhilesh, is married to Sue, and they have one son called Tej. So, friends in Rotary, it's my privilege to present to you our today's chief guest, Rotarian PDG Suresh Hari.
Thank you, Arvind. Welcome, Suresh. We are eagerly looking forward to hearing from you on the story of so many millions that you
have. Story is a good way to put it, but they are also fact. Sometimes stories are a misnomer. Thank you. Nice to have an introduction. Yes, actual story. Thank you, my senior in Roundtable, Arvind and Padmini, whom I know them much before. I see a lot of other Ojas and Narasimhan. Thank you very much for welcoming me to your club and meeting. Cantonment is very close to me because I've always looked forward to Cantonment as one of the very idealistic club where you have your set principles, your path is set, you have certain way of working. Same like Indiranagar. So we all belong to the same breed where we set system and we don't digress from that. And I see that always, including your membership taking, where you meet, time of meeting, everything. So going by that, I have set my clock also. I saw the time given to me is about 25 minutes. I set my clock. Let me try to see how best I can maintain in that. And of course, I see a lot of other Swarup for inviting me and calling on. And of course, you are going to have next weekly meeting, your Ravi Shankar motivating further. Right. And that should be a big boost for the club because he is really a person who will talk from the heart. I see others also. Shivdev was part of my, whenever team, he was part of my team in the district working. And of course, I don't see nowadays Pai around here, Sunil Pai. He has literally vanished. I don't know what happened to him. And of course, all the others, Ramdas Pai, one of the senior most. And of course, Baby Cherian, they are my partners, my club treasurers, Keshav Das partner. And Baby has been always one of the person who comes and presents the budget talk to our club. One of the set meeting we used to always attend. Thank you for all the others who have joined. And of course, IPDG, Bail. You are out of bail now. So you were arrested last year. Now you are out of bail. So good and had a great year. Sorry, you are here. We have to weather most of the time indoor. But it worked better. Most of the production took place in a better way than what we always feel. All the lovely aunts and the ladies in the meeting and the members. Thank you for inviting. It is nothing great that we have to talk to a club like Cantonment. On grant, when you have done on grants like about 36-year-old club with almost 60 members, solid members, I should say, divergent and representing all aspect of the community. I have seen your school project. Both in the city where I remember doing the midday meal program. I don't know whether the project is still coming. Somewhere I read a couple of years back that project you are not anymore involved, but you used to do the midday program where hands-on, your club used to be there and feeding the children there. Such a pleasure on the physical contribution you do. And of course, Chennapatna, I remember the school, you are again hands-off, sitting from here and controlling the operation of that school and fully functional. And that is another landmark of your club. That's the merit of such clubs, which have set a lot of precedents and temper in handling the projects. And how do you plan your way forward? And of course, your club need not be thought on how to do a project or how we can do a project. But once in a way, it is nice to know that refresher, like that revisit what we need to do. Sometimes, you know, as we travel in the path of our journey of 36 years, there is possible that there are a lot of other things have changed around. We should not remain in a cocoon and say that, or like an ostrich putting our head down and say that we are the only one in this earth. So there are others who have grown leaps and bounds. And of course, system may not have set in, but then, you know, they have proved themselves in a different space. And I think it's time for us also to migrate to that space. We need to grow. And Arvind will agree on that one principle of round table we had: adapt, adapt, and improve. Adapt newer ideas, adopt them to yourself, and improve on yourself. That is a wonderful motto. I always call it as one of the life-changing principles of everybody. It can be a round table's motto, but then it is one of the adopting principle every one of us should take it and move forward. Having said that, the lovely projects you are doing, you do at least, I know, a couple of grand projects. Your books are always open. Two or three grants are always open. But what is that? I published my EMGA. Arvind mentioned it. That shows your club has not gone out of the club administration. You have produced leaders of sort who can be really a good material to lead the Rotary movement. But still, your club has remained in a space of contented and being in that one space. So come out and see, you will understand what is there. So there are a lot of things that we need to know, because the members in you itself can be a big teachers for others. You should come out and open up your door for the outside world and push leaders from your club. That is one of the wish I have always. And of course, the place you are staying must be a challenge for you on a year-on-year. And I'm sure the lease and the continuation is taking place on that place. And you remain there, and because your Rotary Center of Learning, no? That is your hall called.
Yes. House of Learning.
Yeah.
So that is a beautiful place. What in the heart of the city, you have a wonderful place to conduct your meeting. I wish and pray that place becomes a permanent abode for you all to have a meeting and continue with your excellent work. And of course, your staff there who does a beautiful job. Coming to the grant, I will share a screen. I published EMGA, the Endowment Major Gift Advisor. It's a 3-year term under TRF, where I'm supposed to be advising Zone 7 clubs. About 9 districts are involved, including 3190. On the major gift initiatives, because perhaps my only merit for that is having been actively involved in large donations to foundation, TRF felt that I can be a good advisor. Let me see, the time only can prove how much of my knowledge or sharing can. I try to do what best I can, sitting across wherever I am. I give newer ideas to the foundation, including Chair Trustee Ravi, and interact with them on how we can approach on this pandemic situation also. I can see when you, I will share a screen, but it is not for a reading, because I don't believe in just a presentation and work on something which is not humanly connected. I would like to have more of interaction than of a show. But since sharing is there, this is one of the recent articles just published. I asked Swaroop to circulate my newsletter. This is the article there. Yeah. This is useful for every single Rotarian who want to look at how to make grant a grand one. See, what is happening today is grant is so much popular. All of you know about matching grant. Those were the days when the Rotary formed the policy of matching grant, where even $2,000, $3,000, $4,000 they had only principle of only matching 50% all that, but TRF and you need a partner who gives 30%, that was there. So we were doing doling out project, like, you know, Rotary, until the strategic new vision came in, they were looking at smaller project. Then there came a thought process that we are just throwing, it's a drop in the ocean. Of course, the drop make a ocean, every drop. But, you know, drop in a ocean is getting diluted. Our projects are not getting identified. Those were the days when, you know, they used to tell the right hand should not know what the left hand is doing. But now are the days when the right thumb finger does, the whole body need to know what you are doing. So this is the day, because unless you show yourself, you have to throw a small fish to catch a big fish. What I mean is, unless you talk about your project, you talk about your what you are doing, your presence and merit is not recognized. Because even in corporate, you can see all of you know about it in the modern. Unless you have a referral, whatever you are not touched. Your CV is not touched. You need to be referred. That referral gives you almost 80% comfort for anybody to just touch the application. So that being the case for a simple employment, your presence of the organization, which is 117-year-old in the global history, it has gone through two world wars, it has gone through pandemic in the earlier stages, it is going through the next pandemic of COVID, which is still surviving and doing great work, need to be recognized. We need to do the tom-tom. I'm not telling tom-tom in the sense personal, which many of us do, some of the clubs, I'm not telling about your club, where, you know, you do a project, go to the hospital, give an apple and pose with the patient when the patient is in pain, and we give a photo, that person will be waiting to ask you to get out, not eat that apple. So these are the things we should stop. Of course, I'm not telling about your club or the other clubs which have a principle of working on actual physical involvement where it is needed. But these are the things which we need to look at, and clubs should be, Rotary as a movement should be presented. In fact, I always tell, when you present Rotary, don't call it as a club name. Call it as a Rotary itself. Like polio drive. Polio is one single name driven by everybody. By just putting Rotary Cantonment, Rotary Indiranagar, Rotary Jeevan Bhimam Nagar, it confuses the community around. What is this? He is different. Rotary should be uniformly identified as one movement and put together. So grant is something, you know, which has not been handled by many clubs. Let us be honest about it. So it's more of a refresh, or I can take a lot of input. I don't mind having more of question answer. I pose a question and you can answer me more at the end of the allotted time. And I would like to learn more from your club also, but at the same time, share whatever knowledge I have. See, there are the I always say, you know, it is going to writing a grant is like going to a supermarket. Only the supermarket difference is it's a high-end supermarket. It's a premium mall. You have to be a little more careful when you enter a premium mall, because there is a tag attached there, such and such spending has to be there, such and such profile has to be there, because you cannot get in and get out simply. So that perhaps that is a different niche area, but we cannot deny that. And when you are doing a grant, the club need to, this is Narasimhan and others, the future leaders, the couple of leaders who are coming in, look at a grant team. It has been a habit. I tell you, I was writing grant almost for the past, I can say, 20 years in my memory. The files I have to go through and clear all those files, which are old. Only about 5 years back, I handed over because they were not allowing me to relinquish my post. I was writing physically those days. Application, we had stencil cutting, and then Xerox came. Then fax came. So these were the methodology where we have to physically send for signature. Now digital signature, online loading, everything has come. But having gone through that, the system is very simple to follow. You have to only follow the principle of putting system in place. The club put a 3-member committee. The committee should be one person should have a 3-year term, the other person 2-year, and the other person 1 year. So that every year you have one new phase entering in there. That person entering in here will have at least 3-year term. So the continuity, because if you see a project, it takes at least for you to complete. We may say, Rotary will say, after finishing, you have to submit. It takes time. Especially during COVID time, you are not able to go out. Your documents, you are not able to reach. Rotary South Asia office doesn't even open your mail for 1 week. There are a lot of challenges for you. So you need to put a system in place, and your club must be having a stewardship committee or what you call as a future planning committee. Future planning committee can look at it and see how best you can. And you know, the grand seminar is something you all attend. I do agree, definitely. Your president and team has always attended grand seminar. Your club has been always a grant eligible club. But having said that, see if some of the new entrants who want to be in that space of grant writing to be also part of that seminar. Nothing wrong. Nobody stops you from taking four members and attending the grant seminar. It is an interesting platform where you can learn the niceties of grant. Don't worry about the mundane talk that is being presented there. But look at, there are also online tools available. Online learning center on Rotary.org. Rotary has enough and more resources. Let us go there. Encourage your members to go to the learning center. It is part of your Rotary.org access. And first for that, you should enable all your 60 members do that Rotary.org registration. Because I always say those who are not registered are all shadow members or ghost members. Because Rotary doesn't identify the activity of such members who are not on such platform where they are not physically logged into Rotary.org. Once you log in, the learning center gives excellent platform for interaction, knowledge sharing, and you can share your knowledge there. It is a wonderful place. Then also, you know, when you are doing a project planning, take input from the community. That is important. I will tell you a small example of our project, which was done with all heart by a club, ended up being a nemesis of sort for the community. One of the Rotarian eagerly went around, was traveling around a village side, and he saw a lot of ladies trekking with the pots on their head to fetch water. He realized that village must be really starved of having a potable water. I went around the village and identified the village and asked them what about. No, there is no well here. We don't have proper borewell also. So the women go every day morning. They trek for 3 hours and bring water for us the whole day. That is what we survive. The men folks don't go. So this man was very eager, went back to his club. He said, I will sponsor the whole thing. Come on, let us go and do a project. This is a very good humanitarian project. So he has not gone about checking with the community there, whether they need a borewell or not to be done or not. But he went and did the project. And after 1 year, they did a grand inauguration. Everything was happy. The borewell was functioning. After 1 year, a couple of members went to the village and wanted to know how the borewell is working. He went to the borewell, was not being used. He asked why. No. Is there a problem? No. Everything is working. They pumped and showed it is working all right. Then what happened? No, sir. The borewell was not used by ladies. Why? What happened? Our ladies were very upset because they felt that 3 hours of time away from the village time is the only time they have a piece of their survival. They used to talk to each other, trek that 2-3 hours that gave them health. Plus, they kept them away from the men folks who are more irritating in the village. So what you have done to the community to benefit them ended up troubling them all the more. It became a nemesis and they themselves shut that borewell. So you need to do a project which touches the community. Touch the community. Do the analysis. Need analysis has become a part of your Rotary submission today. If you don't have a proper recorded need assessment, see, people sitting in Evanston have least knowledge of what is in the ground of Rotary or Rotarians or the ground reality, economic sense. Sometimes they ask silly questions. But you know, the silliness is because many of us in our district or other districts have taken advantage of the distance and return projects which are not at all factual and have also siphoned off money. So they are custodian of our money. Actually, what you are getting from Rotary Foundation is our money. In Rotarian, in somewhere or other given, and it is our money, they are the custodian. So they are only protecting our money. If you take that view, you will have a patience to answer these questions that are coming from there. So have a senior member of your club involved in such discussion. One who is involved in community service project in your club over the years, involve them. Go seriously when you are planning your year about the year in which you want to do a grant and work on it. And for your club, we don't have to tell when you need to reach out to the international partners. Cultivate that partners. Call them for your meetings. Recognize them. Impart. their credentials, recognize them, create sister club engagement. These are something, you know, a club of your sort of 36 year old can usually get better going on that. And of course, then you have a cadre member, or if you have in your district focus area group, like an action group will be there. They can be a good resource. These are some resources that can pre-vet your project so that you don't get into disappointment when you ultimately write the project and you find the project is not grantable. So you can avoid such a pitfall if you really do simple. Like when you go to a supermarket, don't you take your credit card? When you go to a supermarket, you don't want the plastic bag from there, don't you carry your bags? When you go to the supermarket, you need a boot space where you need to keep your item provision, you pick up and come, like that only. You have to be prepared before submission. After going to the supermarket, coming to the checkout counter, you cannot pull out your and see that my credit card is not there, I'll come and pay later. Those things will not work. So you need to be prepared. You'll be irritated. You have to go back because your cart has to be emptied. You will go back to again do the cart picking. So be good in connecting. And your club, I think, has a RCC also. Rotary Community Corps or the village VCC, we call that. You must be having. Cultivate them. They are wonderful platform. They are your ground level workers. They are ground level workers mean they can be really giving their time. They can monitor and they are the eye and ears of yours. They can give you a report. They can, because Rotary looks at how much involvement Rotarians are doing. Your RCC involvement is your involvement. Your involvement, because they are your arms, your attractors, your interactors. They can be a force to send there and for them to monitor. It's not the Rotarian only have to do the job. So you can take them and of all the things, stewardship is important. Stewardship is something, you know, which is many times mistaken. I will tell you, you might be having a goodwill to give a something from your own. Everybody is an entrepreneur or a businessman. You may have some resources to give supply. Suppose if it's you are setting a computer lab, you have a source to give a computer. I will tell you my own example. It so happened in one of the projects in the early years of my writing, Uday Kumar has a computer distribution. We went to him and asked him, sir, we need computer. He said, no problem, Hari. He's like that always. They say, yes. He gave a throwaway price system, new system, HP. He gave a quote. So we put that as a quote and we finalized that as a committee and submitted. Then the TRF came back and said, is that PDG Uday's company? Yes, we said yes. Immediately they said, it's a stewardship issue. He's part of your club. How can he be giving supply? Then immediately I said, I'm sorry, we didn't understand that particular aspect of this. I'm talking about years, about 15 years back. When I apologized, they agreed on that. They understood that it's a sincere oversight, and they allowed that project to go through, and Uday gave an excellent deal of that project. And so if you have resources among your members, use it, but declare it. Declare the TRF in the very first instance that so-and-so, and keep all mail trails. That will come handy because Rotary is flooded with so much of mail. You will not be able to track later on from them. They will ask you to give the submission. You will get irritated. You keep a trail mail of all your communication. They will accept it. If you share them the mail, they will accept it. This is as simple as doing a grant. Create a team. Let the team be patient enough, not irritable. Don't put who as a hyperventilating guy or a lady who is always eager to do fast. Don't push them to take a grant. That is not their forte. They can be on the ground level doing the project. Put on a grant team which is patient, long-standing, which has a ability to respond in time and do the deliverance, what you are looking forward to. They may not be physically involved in the project, but they can at least do a good way of handling your project. You should be able to achieve your slot of 10 open grants every time, I'm telling you. Indiranagar always has 10 open grants. We have ensured that happened because we have mastered the art of writing the right grant. We don't leave it at that. There are some grants which are cleared very fast because we have managed the art, learned, seek help. There are team in the district who can give you, guide you. It is not that 36 years old, give you that 36 years old experience in grant. it is possible somebody with a 2-year-old club with 40 years of experience in Grant. So it is better to reach out to somebody and take that help and do that. We are always good there. And, you know, Grant has another advantage. Your club, I always tell, you know, my Vishwas. In fact, during my year also, we had a lot of interaction and we had worked at how we can enhance the giving by your club. I will tell you, the giving need not be just by giving. I know your club is not the massive giver. I agree on that. You might have your principle. I don't deny that. But having said that, the time has changed. See, if you have only in your vessel, you can give it. You saw that Kuchela or the Purana, he had that one grain of rice in the vessel which was kept aside by his wife, which he offered it to Krishna, which became a flowing Akshaya Patra for him. It will happen to you. There are people who are given and gained more. Next week when you hear Ravi Shankar, he will talk about it. Those who are given have gained more. In fact, what I'm telling is giving has multiple angles to it. I'm not telling blindly give. There are project link giving possible. Like a turn, another 2 minutes for me. So project link giving is there. Like a directed gift, which can be again, you know, I always tell, you know, when you source CSR fund, CSR giving is there. CSR funds are plenty. Don't think that COVID has taken away all your money. There are much more. Out of 9,300 crores that was available, about 7,000 or 5,000 crore have gone for COVID. Balance is still available. It's quite a lot of money available out in the market. They are looking at credible organizations like Rotary. We are the 4-star rated in perpetuity, more than a decade. Nobody gets this rating. So, and you know, another selling point for you. You are giving your time, money, your effort, your contact, your knowledge, and your physical being. Who else can do that? Commercial NGO has almost 20% extra, which is paid. CSR by the government audit even accepts such spending because you need to deploy field force to ensure your project auditability, accountability, implementation, sustainability, and follow-up action, and vendor selection. All these you need. There are consultants. They charge anywhere between 2 to 3% for these services. You end up paying almost 20% as commercial NGO earns it. They are not making your money, but they are deploying their force who are dedicated to do that. What are we doing? That's why I call Rotarian as a Hanuman. Hanuman, because Hanuman is the guy who, for somebody's wife stolen, he went all the way to Sri Lanka or Lanka, burnt his tail and bought back. We are like that modern Hanuman. Rotarians are modern Hanuman who burn our tail and midnight oil and do work for others, which is genuine. So let us be that force, connect with the community, give that extra impetus to the people who want to do service. Go and ask them. Don't shy from asking. Many a time, see, this is another famous thing, Bill and Melinda Gates, when they gave that first tranche of $250 million, somebody asked why you are not a Rotarian. His simple answer, nobody asked me. Whose loss it is? Rotary loss. If he had been part of Rotary, Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation itself will run Rotary. That is the loss. But still, we gained something. So ask, reach out to people for membership, for donation. You don't know, many a time appearances are deceptive. We think, you know, you cannot give. When you ask him, no, you'll be surprised that ask for whatever you want, what best can happen. At best, he may say, I won't give. No, it is not a shame for you because you are not asking for yourself. You are asking for a good cause. Because if you go and tell somebody that somebody, so-and-so, Hari asked for me, they will ask you whether you gave or did not give. Because if you have said you are given, you will be appreciated. If you say you are not given, they will be wondering bad about you, not good about you. So it is not a demerit for you to ask. You are not asking for your personal favor, for your business. Reach out to your members. Those who are, see, give every dollar counts. Whoever can give that extra $1, give that one extra dollar. Go online and give it. You can give it for APF. APF is the one which comes back to the district as DDF. There are other way of directive give. The endowments are there, which in perpetuity comes. Ravi Shankar has pledged for his endowment, that 14.7 million. So it will come in perpetuity. Already he has this year about $20,000 as DDF. for projects across the globe. So when the 14.7 million comes, it will become 10 times. So this is the level of action that we need to look at. Rotary is looking at endowment being 2 billion, 25 million by 2025, 2.025 they call it. 2 billion, 25 million by 2025. Look at enhancing this contribution. Polio needs your support still. Polio contribution goes, every dollar you give become $3 because Bill and Melinda Gates give $2. So I look forward to take that help from you, be that enabler of a wonderful project, be that enabler of lovely grant that you do, be that enabler of Community Connect. Even in this COVID time, we can be a change maker. We are continue being the same. Thank you very much for your time. Thank you for the wonderful audience and the lovely club. I wish you all the best. May you become 60 to 600 member club, quality member. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Suresh, if I may address you.
Hey, Hari, Hari, what's your name, sir? Hari, by any name, will smell a sweet, don't worry.
But don't hurry home, hurry.
Yes, sir.
We need you for some to answer a few questions.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Questions from our grand chairman is missing. He is actually Sunil Pai.
Oh, good. I asked about him. Tell him I asked for the rascal. He will know that.
Yes, you have sent.
You know that Sunil Pai, myself and Pradeep of Bangalore Club is the one who started that music program way back, which we have Antakshari.
Antakshari.
We are the source, seed soils of that program.
Manoj Agarwal, Suri Menon.
They are the current team, yes.
No, they use. I don't know. Suri is not there, I think.
I don't know. He left the club. Yeah.
Suri left the club.
Manoj was the president last year, I think.
Right. Not last year president. Manoj is IFRM, so he's any musical thing is there. Yeah. Yes, Shivdaya. Who else is there? Ramdas must be a senior in the grant. Arvind must be involved in the grant process.
Now retired.
Oh, retired. Don't allow him. Yeah. These are the fellows who just say that retired, but they're not. Don't allow them to use that word.
Arvind is our co-opted director this year.
Good.
We're keeping him in the loop.
They are knowledge bank here. The world is bold.
Absolutely.
So can I ask a question?
Please. Yes, Sushila. Yes.
One of the things that we hear a lot about Indiranagar is the fact that, you know, the your ability, and you did mention it, but I wanted, if you can tell us a little bit more about how you do it, of, you know, the giving, coming back, and your ability to sort of keep a constant stream of these grant projects going. I think every time this subject comes up anywhere, your club is the one that gets picked up as the shining example. So if you can get into it a little more in detail, it would help.
I should tell that Kamala went, Uday's wife. See, Uday set in a lot of principle in the club. And, you know, our club, you know, has a big herd mentality. We follow the leader. And we always say, you know, the current leader is the best. So it is perpetually we have the best of leader in our club. And, you know, we rally around our leaders. Whatever be the action plan he initiates, we take it on our stride. It's others who take it around. We are very productive, proactive. In the sense, we have, it is not that we don't have politics. We do have politics, but it's like a family politics. We set it aside and we move around with the club policies and actions in our own way. And as far as the giving, you know, I told you herd mentality. It is something, you know, we have cultivated as a habit over the years. We have given little more than, I think, almost $2 million to foundation so far. And, you know, we have gained more than $2 million as a grant. That is the magic. You have to see, we have got back more money there from the foundation than what we have given. How is it possible? Because See, the modern day of this directed gift is something, a good tool to sell among your members. You identify a good project for your school, even at Chennapatna or in Bangalore, what you're doing in the East. If that school needs some infrastructure development, not brick and mortar is a no-no, but if it is a establishment of a science lab or your computer lab or the furnitures, write a grant. You have the contact. And seek one of your member who otherwise also you are pumping in money. You have to use your knowledge to make that giving as a directed gift. You know another trick in this directed gift. The district gets the credit of giving. It is not that you are not. Even the foundation grant you do, it becomes a restricted giving, but it is total giving. It comes as in the district account. District governor looks at every drop of giving in any form to foundation because he is constantly probed. He is constantly prodded. And people like us keep on pecking him at every given opportunity to say, please go out, go out, go out. So we have no choice. So what you have to do is the district governor with the available DDF, this is, you know, it's an egg or hen story is something, you know, will not work here. Is it chicken or egg? Even there we have an answer. It is definitely chicken first because I don't think God would have sat on an egg first. Definitely chicken was the first. So here we need to be very clear on our approach. Sell your concept to your members. Ask them to give a directed gift. Today, you know, the grant has become much more easier today because in the pandemic, you are matching by international partner, 30% is gone. You need only a namesake. Even otherwise, if you have a directed gift, you don't need a partner, only namesake. It is easy to sell a namesake partner because they will come on board. Then they will become a giver also slowly. They may come with a $500 giving, but slowly they may give $5,000. Connect with the clubs, overseas club, develop sister club engagement. Don't approach them first with a grant requirement alone. Approach them with the sister club engagement. It is not possible all sister club, all international club give. I tell you, US clubs are the most givers as far as Indian grants are concerned. But still, we have developed few clubs which still give. It is individuals who are expats who are here who drive that. Otherwise, they are looking at Argentina or in Africa. They do project there. They feel India is the biggest giver. They don't need money. Nothing wrong in that. We have reached that space. We are the top world giver, second giver in the world. Because US is the topmost because they are at least 5 to 6 times more than what we give. So it is difficult to match, but we are going there. So we should be working on Sushila. It's not a secret or a magic that we do. It is systemic change that we have bought in. It's a systemic change. Your ideation need to be there with all your club future leaders. Take about 10 leaders. Your club, I'm sure, in my club, if I have to be a president, I take at least 9 to 10 years because there is a ladder which is set in. And once we cross in the ladder, the fourth step, there is no turning back. Till the fourth step, they may be thrown out also, depending on your merit or the wish of the person. But after that, there is no turning back. And if you escape from there, you cannot get into the queue again. So that is the strictness you have to. I'm sure your club also must be having such system. Create the passion in members. Create that involvement in members. When you come to Rotary, I agree physical bonding is the only way it can. But, you know, today, some of the, I am not in agreement of these Rotary mean business and all those policies. I don't agree on that because Rotary is not at all business. Rotary is a business by itself of community doing. So in that, you cannot look at how you can gain. It can be incidental. So develop, cultivate members who have similar mindset. Or if they don't have, cultivate them to become your mindset. Giving, ask them to give. See, Ravi, you have no choice. You have to be a literal beggar. I call you, we are all the Robin Hood, modern Robin Hood. Only thing is we don't rob. We take from the who has and give it to who doesn't have. And the conduit is the intermediary foundation. Be that, Ravi, don't hesitate at all. Don't hesitate to ask. Nothing wrong. You, whether you like or not, you are in that seat now, hot seat. And whatever happens, you are the best. And take up the phone and harass your members. If they cut your phone, don't worry about it. They may be also under tension. But do that call. do that call above, reach out to them. If they cannot give $100, ask them to give $10. If they not give $1,000, ask them to give at least $100. If they're not to become major donor, ask the highest possible. Ask the highest. You will be surprised, Ravi. There are people who give. You think Ajit Rai of my club was not at all for giving to foundation. I'm telling you. Not at all for giving to foundation. During Jagdish's year, he told me. Then earlier itself, I approached him during Nagesh's year as a grant district chair. I approached Ajit Rai. He said, Suresh, leave me. I don't give it to foundation at all. If at all you become governor, you come to me. He said, I use that weapon. I went to him. He obliged me with the AKS. Can you believe it? You have to do this. You have no choice but to keep on hitting. The more you hit, it will bend. It will become malleable. It will become usable by you. You have to mold people. You have to mold members. So, Sushila, it's not a magic we do. It is only a habit. It is a herd mentality. Every leader coming there, as the herd mentality, I have to follow my producer. I have to go behind him and get the maximum possible. So it has become a culture. Develop that culture. That's all.
We did a few things. But before that, thank you so much for a very articulate encapsulation of your... So we did an outgoing matching grant way back in 2012. The first outgoing matching grant from 3190. We also did, I think under Shivdev's leadership, we took baby steps to make this club a Hall of Fame club. So, but now, yeah, we are aging and we need a lot of new members. I have no shame in sharing this with you because we think you are a part of our club as PDG. So we need a lot of younger members and there seems to be some bottleneck there. I think we need to really push to get some young members.
Pushing in members is not a difficult choice, but you know, youngness today has a lot of challenges. Yeah. I do agree. See, I always say earlier also, up to 40, round table is the place one should be. Arvind will agree with me. My molding of being in the public space and what I interact with others is the making of round table. Let me be honest about it. It gave me the freedom. There is no politics there. It gives you opportunity. There is no shyness among. It's a family bonding. It's a lifelong friendship we make. Yeah, it has evolved. Now they have also become a big service organization. That's a different ball game. They are going with the time. Let them do it. But the period we have enjoyed, we have enjoyed. So look at the age of 40 plus. Don't try to take people below that 40. Even I have opinion on Rotaractors becoming member because see, they are building their career. I always say, you know, Rotary has three elements. Family, profession and Rotary, not in any order, but only in that order. Your family comes first. Your profession comes next, next only Rotary. If you have finished these two properly, you come there. Otherwise, you are a parasite. You are here in Rotary for something else. You are not a good family man. You are going to spoil Rotary also. If you have not been doing your business properly, that means you are going to do Rotary also spoil you. So either he has come to spoil you or he has spending while away time or trying to be a parasite on you. So don't encourage people who say, I'm 100% Rotarian. I want to give 100% of my to Rotary. People like me only can give that. If anybody else say that, they are just giving you bullshit. Sorry for that word. But still, don't believe people on. Take people. Be sensitive to their career. Give their time. You have to have a pre-induction. I don't know whether you have a pre-induction talk. I created a document for also assimilation, absorption, and recruitment of members. If you want, I'll share it with you also. There is one talk I prepared. Where, you know, mentoring is very important in Rotary. And equally when member exit interview is equally important. Because more than exit, that person should not be a negative force outside talking bad about Rotary. That can stop many others coming into Rotary. You have to keep your eyes open. And if you had some policy of taking only these people on board, you revisit that. I would suggest you have a strategy meeting with somebody who can establish or run a program for you. We do that program. We have done that couple of times. Once Infosys founder chairman did that program for us. That's about 8 years back. Then we did with Sanjay Dugar ran the program for us, revisiting that strategy planning. It's wonderful. Take your whole club for the strategy meeting. That will make them bond together. It will give them the oneness of responsibility of taking on progress and work the club is doing. Make the member feel that you are not here just to spend your time or we are wanting you to only give your money. It is this knowledge sharing is important. They need to be a knowledge sharer. Rotary is about either he gives a connect, he gives his knowledge or his money. All three in average is the best, but you cannot have everybody. You cannot discredit somebody who gives only his money and doesn't come. You need such Rotarian also. We need to rally around such Rotarian. We cannot restrict with them on attendance, and we have to do certain record keeping. You have to do that window dressing. You have nothing wrong in that, because you are doing good for the Rotary. Look at how you can mentor your new members. Each one. Shekhar, incoming president, has this. Every member, bring one member. How difficult is it? See, if you take your phone book, you may see hundreds of them who can be eligible Rotarian. But we don't do the call to them because they are different in your phone book. Do that effort. Ask your members to go through their phone book and find out at least if they are 4 or 5, let them do that 4 or 5 call. Nothing wrong in reaching out to outsiders and soliciting members. It is no more under invitation, sir. Rotary is not anymore under invitation. We have to solicit members, but mentor them. Mentor them. Don't sell yourself, but solicit membership, mentor them, and make them permanent members. Becoming a Rotarian is only a pinning. But they become Rotarian once they get involved. Give them the ownership of project. Give them a committee responsibility. Mentor them under some good leadership who can at least guide them, not harass them. Give them this, the comfort of being a member, happiness of being a member. But certainly, definitely, you'll have some who will come surely with, I remember the moment they see a club name, they come and ask, you have a swimming pool, you have a table tennis, all that they will ask. They think we are a social club. We have to clear their doubt. It's possible such a person who has a wrong impression may also be a good Rotarian. Tell him that, no, we are this interloper mocking at him and deciding him away. If you perhaps have a patience to listen to him and find his idea, tell him this is somewhere else. But become a member of Rotary if you are interested. These are the things that will give a good opening for keeping your arms open.
Thank you so much. Suresh, if we have more questions from anybody? Completely enlightening on
so lucky.
And walking away from some of our past traditions. So you're saying that it is no longer by invitation, right? So that's a huge yes.
It is in paper, sir. It's in paper, not on practice.
Yes. Mentoring them in the first 3 years is very important. Thank Otherwise, you. We'll lose. Ganesh.
Yes, sir.
Good evening. He's from the same team. You have any questions? You've been in Rotary now for more than 3 years.
No, I don't have any questions.
Where is your Anil Kumar? Is he active or not?
Unfortunately, he left possibly at the cusp of being the president-elect. And so I filled up his space.
Oh, okay.
So, he's not left a very great taste among some of our members, especially who are looking forward to him to become a leader. So...
He's a good contributor. I'm surprised.
Absolutely.
He can be a good contributor. He has done very well in his business and he's doing really well on the space where he is. Good Rotarian. I don't know what happened. I know he was telling that he wanted to be during my year as a president. He was telling. That is long back.
Correct.
But we don't involve in club politics. No, I'm not the one who decide who should be the club president. Though some talk about it, I never believe that. I should rally with who is there then, whom I want. So
No, I think he had some personal, genuinely personal problems. So, but he need not have left the club. That's what he could have taken that sabbatical.
See, look for members, sir. Sell this as a task, no, Ravi. Ask your members to contribute one member each. You have any upper limit? Your founding fathers or your seniors have put a limit on number of members you should have?
No, our founding fathers are a little touchy about the kind of member, but I don't think there's any upper limit.
So, tell them, see, they are well-meaning. They are period. So let us adapt and improve now. You improve on the what is they have set to the process. Even our club, Uday, was very strict on a lot of things. We have evolved ourselves. We may not do 100% of what Uday has told us, but we still respect what Pathy has said, because he is the Pitamaha of our club, who has set the right path for us. He is the one who shown us how the club should be. A systematic, meticulous and methodical club means we owe a lot to him. He has become old. We are missing him. But that doesn't mean that his principles are outdated. There are a lot of his principles still binding us together and keeping us together. That is thanks to him, that vision he had. So similarly, your seniors have left a vision, because if you are 36 years of your continued working in a space and continued community connect, solid Rotary project, it's because of the vision set by these seniors. You have to rally with them. Instead of fighting with them, you need to bring in a blend of youngsters. Think out of box. The youngsters should be more giving ideas to your club. And I suggest have a strategy meeting with somebody who can do that professionally. It is worth the investment. Every penny you do that on that strategy meeting, it is worth the investment, because you can revisit your thought. Even the seniors can. Don't worry about your aging of the club. Aging is not a bane. It's also a boon. So that what you can do is your aging members can come out of their shell also in such a strategy meeting. They may brush themselves. They may look at what... See, do we all are used to this being sitting in front of a TV screen and talking? Earlier, we were shouting at other when the computer is open or a TV is put on. Now we are sitting before a TV 24 hours, attending a meeting or something. So it is something we adopt ourselves. The corona has taught us a new game. Yeah, and it is not going to be a game which is going away very fast. Whatever it be, we may get used to it, we may get adjusted to it, but the fear will lurk for few. At least a decade we'll be thinking about this. Maybe our grandchildren will talk to them later on, say that those were the days that pandemic when it stuck. It was horrible. We led a life of life and death, which is true. Every second we are thinking of death and life. They are the only two options we have. So we are weathering that. So we need to change ourselves. Seniorsness should be made to understand. That can be possible by a professional. Get a professional to do a session for you.
Last few questions on my WhatsApp, one of our members is that, what do you call a person who's donated 100 crores? So he's coming to speak to us next week. So do you have anything bigger than AKS, or what is this? Or multiple AKS?
It is a multiple AKS. They call it trustee circle and keep on going. Beyond 10 crore is some... Beyond 10 million, it is a larger circle. He's the only one in that circle now. So they have not named a special circle for him. Yeah, I call it a Ravi circle, that's all. Ravi circle, your namesake. Who knows, this Ravi also may be in that circle one day.
Oh, I wish.
Ravi is Suryan. Suryan is one which gives without personal self. The sun gives its shine, it doesn't take its shine. So Ravi always give us.
Thank you so much. May I?
And of course, ensure that you have people around in the next week. I will also join if I have the, I think I don't have any, I will also listen to him, because he talks from the heart. Sometimes he doesn't prepare and come. He doesn't believe in preparing and coming. He talks through the heart. And you know, when somebody who has given talks, you know, it makes more impact to you, because he's not talking off the cuff. He's talking what he felt is right. And that I think that should help your club. Ensure that a lot of people attend the meeting. And today is important because those who do the grant being here is more important than everybody sitting there. They may get bored with some of the grant subject because they are not involved in it. I understand today. But for him, at least you should have a larger attendance. That should be a good recognition for him. So market it with your members and ensure that you can share it to other clubs also. They can come on board and attend the meeting. That's one way of getting enough and more people to participate.
Absolutely. But there's a Zoom fatigue which just seems to have set in.
I know. No. All of us are in that. Don't worry.
So, thank you so much, Suresh, for a wonderful session. May I now invite...
Sorry, Kamala Madam. Namaskaram, ma. Morning. Enakku morning, ungalku evening. உதய் சார்
I hope the cantonment club will be come up do all the suggestions. They are very dull and very extremely dull. So please excuse me for all these problems. Okay, thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Okay,
Abhidhi. Our mother said, "What am I saying? Like our number dull at all. His disease is increasing. I think so. Nige, yeah. Endo mukla kiga. I'll talk later.
New Jersey.
New Jersey. Okay. Oh, all my best wishes to you and Anita. I enjoy your talk. Someone sent this by mail, so I just happened to see. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Kamala ji.
Thank you so much. May I invite now Rotarian Nandakumar to kindly come over and propose the word of thanks, please.
Good evening, everybody. I hope I'm audible.
Yes.
Well, actually, I won't be off the mark if I actually say that our club has until recently been quite comfortable raising funds through our internal resources and through some of the CSR patrons. We have done, as our president mentioned, taken the route of the matching grant. But then if you compare the funds that we've raised through that and compare it with the funds that we raised in a comfort zone, it would not be a great amount that we would have raised. But recently, when the pandemic struck us in March this year, we got an opportunity to serve the community on a real-time basis. And that's when we really wanted money on an on-time basis. And in that excitement and exploration that we did, we hit upon this idea of crowdfunding. Well, I don't know if it is really crowdfunding because it was like an American auction. A president used to set a target which he used to have achieved at 12 o'clock in the night, and people used to just put in money as if that was the end of the world was coming to an end. But then we did hit upon that, and I can confidently say that we have sort of specialized in that art, and now we can call ourselves experts in crowdfunding. That aspect has still been continuing, and we've still been raising money on crowdfunding. But today's talk, actually, on this topic of miracle of making a grand one, by PDG Suresh Hari has been an absolute eye-opener for us. Reading his profile and knowing him from a distance, I would call him as a grandmaster who has mastered the art of raising funds, whether it is for the foundation or for the district or for the club. So you have absolutely opened us a new thought process and an action point for a club. And also we are... it has also been educated us, and you know, we have also realized that there is much more that we can do if we pool in our resources with other clubs. We can do a lot of meaningful and mature and long-term projects if we pool in money and get grants and resources from other clubs as well. We are very fortunate, sir, to have you. We know that you're a very busy person. You must be attending so many meetings on Zoom every day, but this has absolutely, we are thankful to you for coming here addressing us and directing us into a new pathway, which we will definitely take up. And we also thank you for the pep talk that you have given us. I mean, the club really needs it. And you have really, I only hope that we had more members to listen, but I'm sure this has also been put on YouTube. This has been live streamed on YouTube. So there will be more members actually watching on that as well. And so thank you very much, sir. On behalf of the president, the board, and the and our club, I extend to you very, very warm thanks for addressing us. I also thank all of the members who have logged in from wherever they are and to attend this meeting. And actually, a big thank goes to the program committee that has been organizing in these severe, challenging times. They've been organizing programs year, week on week. But I would say this one really receives a thumbs up for